Keith King graduated from Auburn University in 1958 with a civil engineering degree.
My mother got up at 4 o'clock and went to work at the Vanity Fair Mills at 7 o'clock, and then she worked from 7 to 4, and she was not home when I was coming out, when I got out of high school or school. I know it's different now, but that made quite an impression on me growing up. Other people had their moms they had to come home to and all that, and mine was never there. And wasn't her fault or anything. She was working to help the family.
Keith's parents worked hard so that he could have the opportunity to get a college education at Auburn. He embraced hardship as a way of life and chose to make the most of it.
They took me to the Monroeville, about 9 miles away. They had a bus station there, and I got my bag, and I packed it up and rode the bus to Auburn, Alabama for my freshman year, my first quarter, and walked to Magnolia Hall off Magnolia Avenue, 37 Magnolia Hall, checked in my dorm room. We had a dorm room reserved, and didn't know a roommate who it was going to be. So I was on my own and met my roommate, and a stranger, and got along fine. So it was, I didn't look upon it as a hardship or anything. It was just sort of the way of life.
During his college years, Keith met and married the love of his life, Julia. The two had some hard work ahead of them, raising a family, and Keith's whatever-it-takes mentality was a large part of his success in both his life and business.
I think my favorite part of the creed is the hard work emphasis in the creed. And I think that's right on. To get the most out of where you want to go and out of anything that you do, it takes hard work. If you're 8 to 5, you don't start worrying about looking at the clock 4 to 5, so you can leave at 5. If you're working on a job, you work on and some more time to accomplish that task, and you do whatever it takes. You know, that's another way of explaining hard work, is doing whatever it takes to get the job done.
And get the job done is exactly what he did, devoting 52 years of his life to engineering at Volkert, an engineering firm based in Mobile, Alabama.
When I first got out of school and went to work, I worked actually with the Department of Transportation for 2.5 years, and then I spent a lifetime with this company, Volkert, that I retired in after 52 years of service. But what we do in my company, and what I grew up doing, was producing a product, and that product was plans and specifications to build and big transportation systems, and I worked at different levels in doing that, drawing up those detailed plans, starting from just building a highway through new ground, or widening a street, or designing the interstate system. First job was the big interchanges in Birmingham, the I-59, and that comes in Tuscaloosa, and the I-20, and the downtown, what we call the route interchange downtown. Big projects like the cable-stayed bridge in Mobile. First cable-stayed bridge in Alabama, and that was a design project of my firm. It was quite rewarding and to be able to be involved in those major projects and to see those things happen. You could see them from start to finish.
Keith always treated his employees like family. His work ethic and reputation with Volkert was an inspiration to the people who worked alongside him.
I remember the first day I went to work there, I closed up my notebook at 5 o'clock, and everybody looked at me like I was crazy. I didn't close up at 5 o'clock the next day. Keith had the energy that most of us, that many people have. He had a lot more than everybody else. But he expected you to have that energy, and he kept pushing you to do what all he wanted to get done, and you did most of the time.
When I went to work at Volkert, there were 6 people in the engineering department in the Mobile office, probably not 20 people with the company. I worked there for 39 years, and when I retired, I think we had 650 people. He is a consummate professional. Professional engineering is a professional business, and Keith deported himself as a professional, and he tried to make the company as professional as he could make it. It was his intent to have a company that satisfied the client in every respect.
We had a very professional environment that we worked in, but we also had that family feeling in the company, which meant so much to all of us. It made us want to do our jobs and do it better. And he was pretty much the leader in that effort.
Back in 2008, I was in the hospital getting a pacemaker put in, and Keith came to see me. And I was sitting on the bed, and he asked how was I, and I said, I'm gonna be all right, I'll be back at work before the end of the week. And he gave me a promotion and doubled my territory I was responsible for while I was sitting on the hospital bed. So I had to go to work on Friday.
He encouraged us, and he was able to pull the best of our work out because of the example that he always set.
In 1990, Keith was named a Distinguished Auburn Engineer and was inducted into the State of Alabama Engineering Hall of Fame in 2002.
I'm very thankful for the education I got and the faculties that that worked with me and it helped mold me and gave me the opportunity to get a good job and gave me an opportunity then to go out and compete in the world out there.
Although he's been recognized by many professional societies and organizations for his accomplishments during his career, nothing has ever meant any more to him than this. Congratulations, Mr. King.